And we know that the sadaqah intercedes for the person and stops the fire from eating the person in the grave. And the sadaqah extinguishes the anger of Allah Jalla wa Ala. And that's why the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to encourage people to give a sadaqah. And we all know when the time of death comes to the person, he will say, Ya Allah, give me a chance. To what? To go and pray, to go do hajj, to go and do this and that? No. فَأَصَّدَّقَ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ فَأَصَّدَّقَ. And that's why the sadaqah has its role in stopping the punishment. And that's why the person should not stop himself from giving the sadaqah. We mentioned to you the story of Abu al-Khair when he used to give sadaqah every day. And one time they noticed that he had an onion with him. So his friend told him, what is this? He said, I was about to give this as a sadaqah. He said, an onion, to give it as a sadaqah, it will spoil the smell of your clothes. He said, I was searching for a sadaqah in my house and I did not find anything except that onion to give it as a sadaqah. So I took it and I said, maybe a poor person will benefit from it. I will not stop giving sadaqah on a daily basis after I heard Uqba ibn Amir narrating that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying that the person will be under the shade of his sadaqah at the day of resurrection. They said the sadaqah of the children, it will definitely reach the parents in their graves. And that's why I advise you, my dear brothers and sisters, whenever you give sadaqah, imagine quickly your parents, whether they are alive or dead, include them in your intention and give sadaqah on their behalf. Allah Jalla wa Ala is rich. He will give the ajr for the sadaqah 700 times, ويضاعف, and he might increase more than that.